Well, good evening, everybody, wherever you are watching around the world. Welcome to European Cricket Studio Live on a Thursday night, and we've been bringing you content every night this week, Monday to Thursday, and that's what we're doing in April, just so that we have something else for you to do at this time, of course, of great upheaval across the world. So we hope you're all safe at home, wherever you're watching tonight. And this is Maximo Chat. Now, if you tune in on Tuesday night, you would have seen the Maximo show with my guest, Pavel Florin. So we had a bit of a chat for about 10 to 15 minutes. And basically what tonight is about is, it's not about Pavel, it's not about me, it's about you guys and about all of us. And we are going to have a chat over the next hour. And of course, the European Cricket Studio will be doing these chats on Wednesday and Thursday nights at this very time. It's 5 p.m. in Central Europe. So we want you to get involved. This is just about all of us coming together and, you know, put whatever you like in the comments, or you can pose a question using the question mark at the bottom of the screen and we'll get to as many as you can, but it can be about whatever you like. This is your chance to get up close and personal with the bodyguard. So big thanks to Michael McCann. I really enjoyed his chat with Ryan Campbell last night, and Michael, of course, will be back on Monday and Wednesday next week. I'll be doing the Tuesday and Thursday shows. Well, I know you're not here to see me. Why don't we bring on my first ever Maximo Chat guest? It's Pavel Florin.
Hi, Vinny. Hi, everybody.
Hello, Pavel.
Good to hear you, the everybody.
Yes, Pavel, it's great to see you. And firstly, I just want to ask how you're going and what's the situation like in Romania? Just briefly, are you in your house at the moment pretty much all the time?
Yeah, I'm in my house and I try to improvise something to can talk. I use my bed. I use a letter to bring my phone up and we can talk. So well, the situation in Romania is how is everywhere. The police, the armies in the streets, the people stay in house. But I hope be positive, everybody, and take back our favorite sport and our love, the cricket.
Well, look, I made a bit of a comment today, Pav, that on social media that, you know what? The coronavirus isolates from Pavel Florin. So that's how I approach the situation. What do you think at home? So just a reminder, I've got a couple of questions that have been sent in for our guests, but we want you to pose questions in the question bar down the bottom, or we might ask you some questions and we'd like to hear what you've got to say and what your opinion is. Why don't you put in the comment bar now where you're watching from around the world, and we'll give you a shout out and invite you into the conversation. So I've got a question to start with. That was sent in a couple of days ago, and I wanted to ask you this. This is from Ram, who's in Chennai in India. He wants to know, Pavel, what is your favorite cricket shot?
Oh, my favorite cricket shot is a little complicated. It's just it's not for the beginners to say like this. Is a reverse scoop. I don't know
The reverse scoop. Okay, so let's explain this to everyone, because when you were in Australia, you told me that you'd invented a new shot, and I was very excited about this new shot. And do you remember what that was, what you told me at the time? I have my recollection, but tell me about Pavel's amazing new shot.
I don't know, it's the same shot with the reverse scoop. In Australia, I have some shots in the training, in the field. But show to the people the shot, and after I explain my shot.
Well, I do remember what you said to me at the time before I bring the footage up, is you said, it looks like you're going to go and do a reverse, and then you don't do a reverse. And I just said, so a normal shot. But, you know, I love the way that you approach things from a different angle. And, yeah, we do have... some footage here. Now, this was an incredible shot. I'm not sure you can see it there very well, but this is one which has gone into the Swan River in Perth off a very, very good bowler from the Melbourne Cricket Club. This is, he plays one level below first-class cricket in Western Australia. And there's the, that's just the reverse whack, Pav. Talk us through this one.
Yes, in Melbourne Club, the bowler was the very, very good and tried to bowl me and tried to make me to be hard for me. So I need to improvise and this shot is coming out.
Well, we had such a good time, didn't we? Not only on the cricket field, but also off. And this is a bit of a blended shot. This is us down at the beach. And look at this guy. He'd never even seen slips before because he's only played short form cricket. And luckily, this is actually Josh Phillippe, wicket keeping behind me, Sydney Sixers, and I think future Australia superstar. And what did you think about slips catching, Pavel? Because I know that when you came to Australia, you hadn't done much slips catching.
Yes, here was the first time when I play beach cricket. So you guys, you born there and everything you do on the beach. And for me, it was a little harder, but I tried to have fun and play cricket also there. So... You are wicket keeper. Josh Phillippe was wicket keeper, and I tried to do my best.
Yeah, well, Baldy says beach cricket in the Olympics. Now that's fantastic. They've got beach volleyball in the Olympics. I don't see why you couldn't have beach cricket in the Olympics.
What idea?
It was fun playing on the beach, wasn't it? There's so many things we could do.
Yeah, beach cricket in Olympics is a very good idea, and. I think it's very, very fun.
Now, I worry because in Australia, the beaches are very clean and beautiful and we can play cricket on the beach. But I worry if, you know, there are some beaches in India with some suspicious looking debris. So maybe that would be a little bit worse a place to play. So I know they play in the street a lot in India. If you're watching right now, why don't you tell us, where do you like to play cricket? Is there an unusual place that you play cricket? Put it in the comments or shoot us a question. Where's the most unusual place you've played cricket, Pavel?
So the best thing since now was Australia, but in my journey, for sure is India. India, I want to play on the streets. I don't need a stadium to play cricket. Right now is good a street or a park. Of course, India. I tried to go in Pakistan, but it's coming this coronavirus, and I can't go. So this also, I have many friends in West Indies, in Trinidad, Tobago, or
that'd be nice.
Bahamas, and one day I want to go also there.
Yeah, well, you know, there's lots of places that people play cricket, and you mentioned a few there, but, I mean, we used to play in my office with a softball. I mean, that's the great thing about cricket. You just need a bat and a ball. Now, we've got a few comments here from Daniel and Yannick, and they're talking about cricket in the Swiss mountains. Now, this was – did you see this, Pav? This is a tournament that's played every year.
I stay home. I just imagine how is to play on the ice. I don't have the time and the money to go there. But for sure, one time in my life, I go there and I play also ice cricket.
Well, Animad says he plays cricket in the car. I want to know how you can play cricket in the car, Animad. Do you mean you're a... You're watching cricket in the car or actually playing cricket in the car? That sounds quite unusual. I'd like to know a bit more about that.
Yes. Imagine this. Cricket in the car. How we can do... I dance in the car with my gloves, with my bat, with everything. But play cricket in the car...
Yeah, it's something I haven't heard. Playing in the back seat. Well, maybe Animad has a big... a big backseat. And I don't know if that's the only sport he does. We've got some footage up. This is cricket on ice in Switzerland from February. And it was about minus 8 degrees centigrade. So it was very, very cold. But that was a pretty amazing experience. You see some of the views here in the background. So Pavel, you know what? Maybe we'll speak to the organisers, because I'm sure you would love to play cricket on ice. You see some.
I know
some
you were
there,
and I was very, very, very jealous of you, because don't say Pavel, come with me, but I forgive you because you are my friend.
Well, I wouldn't want you showing me out, but you can see. Look at the backdrop here. Such a beautiful part of the world. Now, we've had a few other questions for you, but we'll come on to it in a second. Of course, we talked about some of the more unusual aspects of your life for an international cricketer, such as your experience in the armed forces and trying to get into the French Foreign Legion. As we say hello to Philly there. And Animad says that beach cricket is a great one for us in Barbados. And you said how we went in a boy and came out a man, and that you learned patience. So how important do you think patience is in the game of cricket? And do you have any still?
So be clear. I learned the patience outside the cricket. In the cricket field, I don't have patience because I have a big emotion and I want play. I want hit. I have one throw. And sometimes you need patience. Don't be so quick. I don't have this patience in cricket, but in my life, you know, my job is be a bodyguard, and I work in the nightclubs. And there you need patience for people like you, for example, or for another people who have problem when we drink or another things.
Well, I'm not that happy that you called me out as someone you need to have patience with after a couple of drinks, but it's probably fair. Now, we've had a question come in on the question bar. This is from the Cricket Connoisseur, and they have asked, what is your favourite delivery, Pav? So I think it might be when you're bowling, what is your favourite delivery to bowl? Do you have an answer?
I have an answer. What is my favourite bowling style, no?
I think so. Do you have a special ball or a favorite ball that you like to bowl?
The grenade, just the grenade, my slow bowling and the loop. And these make me famous, this throw. But in the time, I learn another style, and I have maybe two or three different bowling styles. I don't know is the my favorite. My favorite is the first. Is the grenade.
Your favorite is the grenade. But as you said, you've got a couple of different balls now. I've seen you bowl a little bit of a quicker one as well, which not everyone has seen. But I love the way that you would bring variety into the game. As we say hello to Kanan and hello to our friends at the Centre Square podcast, the Centre Wicket podcast. They're tuning in to say hi. If you have any questions or comments for Pavel, please put them in the comment bar, or you can shoot us a question down at the question mark there. So yeah, we did all sorts of things, didn't we? But I liked in the games where you would say, when I was wicketkeeping, you'd say, Vinny, it's the number two now, it's the number two. And you had these, you were trying to confuse the batsman that we had some kind of a plan. The guy turns to me and says, what's the number two? I said, he's just making it up.
No, I am
from
out for a time I come, and now I am not so great like another bowlers. So need have my tricks. And my tricks is coming from another sport. And you need to play with the batsman head and say words and... In another sports, you have different tactics and say the plan number two, the plan number three. The batsman is thinking, what is this? In another time, I speak with one player and say, go there, come there. There is coming the ball. Now it's short, it's short, it's coming to you. I'll show you. And the batsman head is like this. He don't know what happened. and
you're really getting in their head.
My close friend is the wicket keeper. No, I need to talk with the wicket keeper. But we talk rubbish, nothing serious.
Some people would argue you're talking is rubbish and your bowling is rubbish, but your bowling's quite effective. And we know you weren't hit for a six in the European Cricket League last year. Now, we've got another question which I'd like to bring up. This is from Harish, and he says, which batsman do you dream to bowl against one day?
This is a difficult question because I don't think it. I think to play. And I want play against the tough batsmen in my country or in Europe or one day in the world, of course, and see my limits, how I am good or not. But I don't have a name. I have friends. I have good batsmen friends. And one day, for example, Chris Lynn is one of my friends and I won't play against him. So I want against you play Vinny one day because also you are a good batsman. So
you're too kind. No, thank you.
I don't think I have a great name in my head to have an answer.
Well, I know that you got the chance to bowl to Brian Lara in an office while you were in Australia. You got the chance to refuse bowling lessons from Jeff Thompson when you said, no, I don't want to bowl fast, thanks. I'm a slow bowler, which everyone who knows anything about cricket found very amusing. We have Aaron saying, Pavel is awesome. So that's fantastic. Ram's just commenting that you went 62 kilos to 85 kilograms of pure muscle, and you still are pure muscle. And we've got Rakic from Rakic 15 from Perth saying, please come back and play for Subi Maris again. So shout out for the Subiaco Maris Cricket Club where you made some appearances in Perth.
For next season is possible. Of course, I've come back to Perth because it was a great time for me there. And in West Australia, it was a bless for me.
Well, the Centre Square guys, Centre Wicket podcast guys, wanted to know, what is the favourite thing you did in Perth? Of course, my hometown. What is the favourite thing you did in Perth? Maybe except for playing cricket, because we know that would be your favourite thing. But what was the favourite thing you enjoyed about visiting Western Australia?
We talk about cricket. Every day in Perth, I play cricket. So what I can say? I see one day the kangaroo and the another animals. And here you feel me and... I don't know it, and I test how is it?
So this is Vegemite. I brought this up because this is one thing you did in Perth. This is a very Australian thing. Vegemite, it's a spread that you can put on bread or toast. It's got a very distinctive flavour, and not everyone likes it. I mean, I think you are quite brave. We know you're a brave man. What was tasting Vegemite like?
It was a different taste. It was the first time I tasted. And the people look at me to say, is good or not good? And I need to say it's good because it's Australian, of course.
Oh, well, we do appreciate that. And so we've got, I think we had a question from one of your teammates. It could be Vasu Saini asking, where do you get so much energy from, Pavel Florin? Where do you get your energy?
You know, when you are old, you don't have anything to do, just have energy and enjoy the life. So I leave all my problem of the doors and I live my dream and I live my life. This is the answer. You need live. When you live, you have a good positive energy. You like this. You left when is coronavirus outside. It's not problem.
It is important, and we love that motivation and determination that you bring to your game. Vasu says some lol faces there. Vasu, feel free to spill any dirt you've got on Pavel in the comments. We do appreciate it. We are reading them, guys. This is all about all of you to get involved in the broadcast tonight, the Maximo Chat Hour, all the way to the top of the hour. Now, the Centre Wicket podcast, Centre Square podcast, guys, said thoughts about your fellow Centre Wicket podcast guests, Aaron Summers and Josh Phillippe. They were both guests on the Centre Wicket podcast, which we were lucky enough to go on. So yes, tell us a little bit about Aaron and Josh Phillippe.
This is I don't know this has happened, but Aaron and Josh is two are my friends, and we are very good friends. We speak weekly, and in the past when there was the Big Bash with Josh, I speak every match, and I say for beginner, this is your the best competition in your life. This was because it was in my opinion, and more opinion, was the best wicketkeeper in Big Bash. But somebody take this trophy, but in my opinion, Josh was wonderful in the field. So what was the question again?
Because I was just getting your thoughts on Josh, and just while we're on Josh Phillippe for a second, he's a former teammate of mine as well. Now, do you think we should get him on the Maximo show to have a chat with Josh Phillippe from the Sydney Sixers? Do you think he'd be a good guest?
You can't make a trap for him. A trap is a joke, a funny joke. He likes the joke. So make something funny for him, for Josh, please. And say this is the gift of Pavel. But yeah. Something.
Well, you said to Josh that you think he's going to play a really, really good game. And then he turned out to be the player of the final of the Big Bash League in Australia, playing great innings opening the batting. So,
when I go in Perth, first day I call Josh, we don't know each other, and I say I'm a president of Cluj Cricket Club, and I want to come to play in my team. And Josh say, but not now, because you're not ready for Cluj Cricket Club. And wait a little. Tell how you move, and I come here to see you how play, and after we decide if you can play for Cluj Cricket Club. This was my first first time when I talked with Josh Phillippe.
Yes, I remember you said that, and you sent him a video saying, Josh, I hear you're an up-and-coming player. Maybe one day you'll be good enough to play for Cluj. For now, I'm prepared to make you play a number 12. I think was you trying to say 12th man.
Something so like
you spurred him on there.
You just imagine Josh say, "Wow, who is this? Who? What is what?"
Oh, he knew who you were. I've got another question for you. Now, this came in from Mal Campbell, and also Daniel Wesson has posted. Are you aware you've been nominated the best overseas player by the great cricketer tonight?
Wait, if he's Campbell is a president, so with the president you need to talk like this, because you need...
Oh, I see. Oh, you've got your Surrey Hills cap on. I see. The Melbourne club you played for.
What?
That's your Surrey Hills cap and your Surrey Hills shirt?
If he's here, the president, you need to put this in your head. This is official. Now, I wait the question from Mel Kelber.
So he wants to know if you've been... Did you know you've been nominated as best overseas player by the Grade Cricketer? Were you aware of that? Tonight, this afternoon.
Yes, from some hours ago. It was a surprise also for me. But I don't understand for the first time the prize. I was the first selected, and say Pavel Florin is the winner. And I say, yeah, in my house. But I don't understand what happened after I realized, because nobody tell me. So,
it's a big honor.
And I'm very happy for this. It's not the first prize, but it's a welcome prize in this moment, and make me more ambitious to play cricket in my style. And the grand cricketer maybe one day give me another prize for bowler or for best.
That was their annual awards. And hi to Cunningham Finn. Thanks for tuning in, and hello also to Hassan06 for joining the chat. This chat is all about you guys, so please put in the comments whatever you want to talk about, whatever you want to ask Pavel or myself. And we've got Nishil here, who is asking, Pavel, please reply, do you remember taking 3 wickets against East Malvern? Now, I think that might have been in Melbourne.
I read the people of what say, and I don't pay attention on the question.
That's okay.
Please.
So he wants to know, do you remember taking three wickets, getting three people out in Melbourne against East Malvern, another club?
Yes, I remember
taking three wickets.
Yes. Also, the people don't know, I play with the president of the club, with Mel Calburn, and he take two of these wickets in his hand, and was his in all the season he don't take any ball. He was in one match he have three catches. The president, who was in my bowling, was the best of Australia. My best bowling in that match, and I have three wickets and three catches in one match. So I was very happy. Not,
I saw the highlights as well. It was incredible work, actually.
Every time in Australia, you take this because there is many good batsmen, and it was a pretty good team I play. I remember, and I was very, very happy. And all the team also, we have almost a victory, we lose, but I was happy.
Yeah, well, it's great you're enjoying your cricket now. Italian Cricket TV, who do some great work in Europe. I've even seen them doing a few Maximos as well in some of their broadcasts. So hello to all you guys at Italian Cricket TV. They have a question for you. They said, how disappointed are you that ECL 20 has had to be postponed?
Yeah, what I want to say to Italian Cricket TV is my friend also. We talk each other's. It's hard to take this because, all the team, my team is prepared. The boys was very motivated. They know now what happened in ECL. We prepared another tactics. We prepared our physics. It's another chance for us. And it's coming this, and our soul was broken. And I don't know. Now we try to recover this problem. I hope next year Cluj be there, and for sure is coming there, and recover this year and come more strong.
Yeah, well, that's fantastic to hear your thoughts on that, and we have to be philosophical at times like now. And so, of course, ECL's not going anywhere. We'll be right back there in 2021, bringing you all the action. Now, I've got to keep these questions coming, and these are great.
It's about us, the team, or Cluj Cricket Club is here. It's about ECL to prepare, because we are coming for sure, and we are more dangerous this year. It's not... this coronavirus is go, but we are here and we are prepared.
Sure. Now, Ram has another question. He's watching the broadcast. Hello to Ram. Hope you're enjoying it. Now, this is a pretty fun question. He says, to Pavel, if you get the opportunity to rename the sport of cricket, then what would you name it, just for fun? That's the sort of question that you love, isn't it?
Yes, I need to think something. I don't know. My English is also bad. I know the answer in Romanian, but in English is very, very...
Well, you can give us the Romanian, that's okay. Grenade toss or something?
In Romanian is lovita. Is like hitting sport or something is in Romanian, but in English is very hard. I need to think about this, and... Ram, I think overnight, and I send you an answer.
Okay.
Answer.
Well, that's nice. Now, we had the Center Square podcast making the question to me, actually. How robbed do I feel of not winning the Fox Cricket commentary competition? Oh, ouch. Well, I did post a video just for a bit of fun to the Fox. So you think you can commentate? Now, I didn't win. Now... I think it's because I was a little bit risque in my submission. So I said one thing which perhaps they didn't want to air, and that's my theory on it anyway. But the guy that won, he did impressions of everyone, and he was actually pretty entertaining. So I don't mind If that's what they were looking for, then that is absolutely fine. So I'm keep plugging here. And so I'm enjoying my work here at the European Cricket Studio all April with these shows and these chats and the chance to chat to all our fans and for you to say your piece. So thanks. I think that might have been brave. I appreciate that. Now we've got another one for you, and this is
let me answer to do a question because somebody from Marrakesh is Mr. Felekan Andrei. I don't I know the guy, and he's one of my good friends, and I was in Marrakesh and ask him when I go back in Marrakesh and I make a new team there. So it's not a bad idea because it's some teams in Africa, in also in Marrakesh is not a functional team, is an opportunity. And who knows, maybe next year I go in that part and I try to do something.
Love to watch you spreading the word of the game to new places. This is a question which I'm very interested to hear you answer. This is from Dan at ECL. Wants to know, what's Pab's fitness regime like now? How are you keeping fit and strong? What are you doing at the moment?
It's very hard to do something, but what is my opinion, in this time the doctor can do many things for you. Everything you need, you see the doctor do. If you have a good health, you survive. This is normal. So, people, do sport. You don't have many space. I am not now a trainer, everybody's trainer in the house and show you exercise. Just do sport, please, because this is life. The sport is life. Here in Romania, we stay in the homes and we have a half hour, maybe 1 hour to go around the house. I stay in the big building and I don't have space where I run, but I run in around my house. My block here is maybe 200 meters around. Every night, 1 hour, and after 1 hour, I come in my home and do the physical exercise. This is the answer for coronavirus, in my opinion. Be healthy and make sport.
Sure. And, you know, a bit like your cricket, you have to improvise according to the situation and find your own way to do it. Now, this, I'll give one more to Nishal here, and thanks for tuning in, Nishal. This isn't really a question as much as a comment. He says, Pavel, grass grows faster than your deliveries.
Yeah, but...
Do you think that's fair?
Who take this question?
This is Nishal. He's in Melbourne.
You can stay in front of my bowling? I ask you, Nishal.
Nishal, would you face Pavel?
My delivery is
shaking in his boots.
Slow, and go. What you do? You panic. This is the answer.
I've seen it happen. I saw it happen when you played here. They had probably the best batsman on the other team when we were playing for a team called the Cowboys. Don't know if there's any Cowboys watching tonight, but the Cowboys in Western Australia. And they had one very good batsman, and he just wanted to get off strike to you. He was too scared to face you. I've seen scared batsmen before, normally because they've got bouncers coming at their head. But Nishil, he did not want to be there, did he? He was it's sorry, not your problem.
Nishil, answer, I smash you multiple fours. Why not sixes, Nishil? I ask you, because it's fours, maybe. Because you don't go up. When you go up, you are out. Because you can't hit me for six. For four, maybe. For six
there's fighting words. I love it. There's fighting words there. Oh, hi to Cloudy Young. It's nice to have... a diversity of viewers there. We've got some female viewers as well and people all around the world. So I'm happy that you're enjoying yourself. There's a question of from Baldy about the European Cricket Series, the Dream 11 European Cricket Series, which debuted. Now, Pavel, there's some footage that I want to show you. Now, this is from the Dream 11 European Cricket Series in Spain. Now, unfortunately, of course, there's no cricket being played at the moment. But have you seen this? Now, this is I've forgotten this gentleman's name. Now, this is a bit of fielding. It was like four wides. And then the fielder chases it. This is in Alicante. And then, ouch. And there's only one pole around the whole ground. Look at this. This one again. Now, Pavel, talk us through the fielding. Did you do everything right here, or what happened?
Just see again. They have a good speed here. But where is looking? He don't see this obstacle.
I know they say keep your eye on the ball, but I think he's done it too much in this footage. And I must admit, like, you see the other guy, they're just checking if he's alive walking around the ground. So, I mean, Pavel, if that happened, if you did that, the post would go flying out of the ground. Maybe this guy's not strong enough.
I don't know. I can't say this, but in the past, I play American football, and these kind of things is happening in American football every game. Of course, you have a helmet and you have a protection on you, but I think I'm a strong man.
I know you're a strong man. Now, to his credit, that fielder got back up and went back to his position at short third man. And then, believe it or not, this is two balls later. Now, watch this one. The ball goes up. It's a catch. It's dropped. Just wait till you see the replay of this. He gets up, throws it in. The batsmen go for two, and there's a run out. And then, Pavel, why don't you commentate the replay when it comes up, and you'll see exactly what happens.
We have him. So the cricket is not for pussy. In normal case, is go out and say, I'm broken, I go out, I need a doctor, spray,
just watch
spray.
This. Just quickly, spray. Pat, watch this. It's like right in the head. The same guy that just clotheslined himself. He got hit in the face. He headbutted the ball.
Please don't look like this, the things. This guy is a hero, no? This is coming back to play after that hit. He's coming back to play. After that ball who hit his head, is go after ball, pick it, and take a wicket. He's a fighter. I have all my admiration.
I like it that he did get back up. He was pretty tough. And we talked about balls hitting people the other day when we were talking about futsal and goalkeeping. Hello to Rizwan. And welcome to the show.
Hello.
Any questions you've got, put them in the comment. We had Cloudy asking, she's asking about girlfriends. Do I have a girlfriend? Well, I don't currently, but I don't think people care about me. How about you, Pavel? Do you have a girlfriend? And if not, why not?
I'm in the same situation like you. So we wait from time. You know, when you have this job, I have this job in nightclubs, it's very hard to have a family and have a girlfriend, to stay with the girlfriend and be like everybody. So when you have a girlfriend, you don't have time for many things. Also, you don't have time to go and play cricket. So it's better without girl and be a hunter. This is my...
to be a hunter. Well, we talked about your... Cloudy says, beating the women off with the cricket bat. I think that's what Pavel's last 10 months of his life has been. Basically, I remember there was always two types of partner, wife or girlfriend. The type that hated you playing cricket because you went around, or there was the type that just couldn't wait to push you out the door and tell you to go to cricket. So it depended which type you got.
When we push you up is after 2 years of marriage. So don't show this photo, please.
Well, Cloudy sounds like she's enjoying... She's enjoying asking you these questions. So if you missed that on the show the other night, this is Pavel in, looks like some sort of a calendar or something like that. That's a pretty old photo though, isn't it? We had to dig that one out.
22 years ago, I was in the army, and where I was is not allowed. The photo was a special force, and there everything is secret, and you can't make photos and show the pistols, the guns. And we make this photo and some superior or some captain find our photo and throw out all the photo and throw. Well, and I go to jail for 1 day. I go and
Is that
stay.
Right? You're in jail.
In army, they have their jail.
Army jail.
One day in the jail, and wow. When I come back, I find all the little pieces of the photo and put it together, and this is the result.
Oh, wow, and well, we've certainly got enough mileage out of that. Now, thanks to Cunningham Finn for a question, and he asks you, what is your highest score while batting? Great question, Cunningham.
Yeah, my highest score was 46 or 48. I don't remember well. We was in Romania, and in that time, I don't know how I realized it, because I drive 500 kilometers from in the night, and in the morning I have the game, and I was number six or something, and the first batsman go out very quick, and I stay there 14 overs, and that is my highest number of my betting.
Oh, thanks for sharing that. And this is another question from K Rakic 15. He is actually tuning in from Australia and says, what was your most memorable moment while playing cricket in Australia?
Is many, many moments. The people see like this, the cricket, not like me. They see to wait to answer when I meet Brian Lara, or when I was to the test match, or Jeff Thompson when I meet is the best moment, but not... I think the best moment can be when I go in a gym, a big building, when is indoor cricket, and it was free field. I never in my life see something like that, and I stay like a child there. If you remember, Vini, I stay there. I stay and I want play, and I say, Vini, please don't find me, please, a place to play. And you go and talk with the guys, and the guys say, oh, come, but they don't know this is Pavel, and let me play. This can be one of my best moment in the Australia, but of course was many of this moment.
I was actually really annoyed because indoor cricket is a separate branch of cricket that is played particularly in Australia, South Africa, New Zealand, a few other countries, and I've actually played indoor cricket for Australia. So all these people at the indoor cricket centre knew who you were, but they just kept asking who I was, which I found really a little bit. And my ego was just...
You tell me you are in your... This is your house. You are there, the favorite man.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, not to everybody. Now, I've got another viewer question that came in. And again, you can ask us anything. And this one came in after the Maximo show on Tuesday. And we saw it just referenced there. Vinny, what is that thing on your face? Was the question. And I can actually tell you that it was from Caroline Sandu, who's my mom. And I can explain. So this is a relatively recent addition here. And coincidentally, I did it just for a bit of fun when I was hosting on March 14, I think it was. And I thought, oh, you know, I'll just shave around it. And but now I've decided that while the corona is consuming the world, I'm going to keep it and I'm going to keep growing it. So I call this my corona patch. So what do you think, Pavel? Do you think maybe you could grow a corona patch?
Yeah, his idea. I work on this, but here is not a good place. Maybe here something. I don't know.
Back there. About this. You have been to jail. We know that now. You've been to army jail. So maybe, I don't know, you need to get like a teardrop. What do you get when you go to army jail?
The army jail is different. You don't go and stay like this. You work there. And the people work you in the jail.
Yeah, well, you know, we've got some more questions coming in. So we've got some other questions, and it's another one from Nishul. He wants to know, will you be coming back to Surrey Hills? Will you be coming back to Australia next year? If so, he thinks he'll hit you for a few sixes. But seriously, would you like to play in Australia again, or is there anywhere else that you'd like to?
I was in Australia and I play in Australia. Is a single place after Romania and after Spain where I play serious cricket, and it was my dream to reach there before to be famous. So I like Australia. I go for a week and I stay a month. So I hope next season go back and stay more. This is my goal now.
We're talking about your indoor cricket. If you haven't seen it, this is Pavel taking his first wicket in indoor cricket with his new friends. They were short a player. And you had no idea that was out, did you? You didn't know you could get caught off the fence like that?
I think it is a six because the ball is touch the back nets. So I don't know what happened. Everybody come to me and say, oh, but I was like this. I don't understand. After I asked the guys, why is wicket?
That was some good accuracy, actually. And I noticed that about your bowling when you were in Australia is that you had obviously worked on your accuracy. So it's sometimes, and one of my coaches used to say, it doesn't matter how fast you put it there, but you need to put it in the right spot. So that's one thing that I noticed when you played both the outdoor and the indoor varieties, that you'd worked a lot and you didn't bowl a lot of wides. And I think, is that something that you think has improved in your game, the more that you've played and the more that you've bowled?
Yeah, I work from... in my house, when I come back, I work on my bowling, and now I don't throw many whites. So, also in Australia, I throw, I don't know, in 8 overs, maybe 3 or 4 whites. So, my bowling is growing, but I need to show this. Now is not the moment, maybe next season is. And next ECL, for sure, the batsman... will have a problem with me.
Just quickly, we've seen a comment about you hoping to start a Romanian women's team. Is that something that you're working on at the moment? What's the state? Is there any women's cricket played in Romania currently? I wouldn't imagine that there would be much.
No, it's not a team of Romania. Romania, we have some girls who play cricket, but with us. It was a plan, but now... Now is this situation, I can't talk what happened next, because we don't know. The sport is now, the first he was hit, and he was hit in the budget, the first. And I don't know what happened, I can't answer. It was a dream to make a woman teams. Maybe this dream is continue.
Sure. Well, we hope that's something that we can work on and spread the women's game, of course, further afield as well. I'm sure we'd love to have a women's ECL down the track as well, or women's ECS as well. That'd be great. Now, here's another question. We're running out of time, so I'm going to burn through a few of these. Hello to Ralph the Man, the Catalonia wicketkeeper, and one of my favourite people to watch on the ECL cricket field. He's joined the chat. Nice to see you. Now, this is Kiss Roberts says... Can you please tell us some good memories about the sports you have managed or practiced before? So non-cricket stories,
yes,
or non-cricket sports.
Who don't know, I was after I was goalkeeper in futsal, I was trainer, and I train a junior squad, and I pick up the boys on I can say on the streets was the boys, and I make a team, and I go with this team in the national championship, and we have the last chance to win. It was 20 teams, and we win the championship. Nobody was professional in my team. I not was the trainer with the paper, but we have a good unit, a good team, and believe what I said, and it was the best achievement in the sport in my life. But of course, nobody know this. I was very, very proud of this, that kids, now they are grow men. And thank these kids if somebody see me, because we make a so great team.
That's inspirational. And I know you've got, that's not the only sport that you've been involved in as well. There's so many others. We're going to keep going. Now, my colleague, Michael McCann, this is McCann. Of course, Michael will be back on Monday with a special guest who I'll reveal shortly after we finish chatting with Mr. Florin here. He says, Pavel, if you could change one rule in cricket, what would it be and why? So if you could change a rule in cricket, what would you change? It's a very good question.
A rule. I don't know. I changed that. Spray. No, I'm joking. I don't know. Maybe I play many times the number 12 and nobody let me bowling and bat. So it's very hard to go number 12 and you can't do anything. Just be there because you are a 12th man. It's an ugly name, this, the 12th man. Maybe I change this rule for the 12th.
There are some tournaments where the 12th man is allowed to be a bit more involved in the game. So that's a very good one. And I like that. We've got hello to Brown TBK. Says, te cuesta hablar en inglés? Now, I'm learning Spanish at the moment. Did you know that, Pavel? I'm learning Spanish, so hopefully I'll know a few more words.
I'm not very confident with you. You need demos.
You don't think so?
No, say something to me, like Pavel, I don't know. Something
is... La casa roja es nueva. It means the new house is red.
Everybody knows
this. You say that to the bank. Moving right along. What time is it over there, says Ethan. Hello to Ethan, wherever you're watching. Hello also to Mark.85. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget, we're doing these every Wednesday and Thursday at the same time for this whole hour. So we want to get you involved and make sure you come back. Tell your friends this is on and let's grow this community and talk about some cricket, talk about anything you like in these hours. I'm going to pick another question out, Pavel. Oh, here's a good one from TK. It says, did you get up to any mischief while over Australia?
Mischief? What is mischief? I don't know.
Mischief is, did you get up into any trouble? And not serious trouble, but...
The Australian is very good people. Why I have trouble in Australia is it's very chill. Everybody's chill there. They don't have problems. They don't... I don't see any angry people. I don't know. Here is different.
Did you get up to anything cheeky, though? Did you do anything a little bit cheeky? Like, not big trouble. Like, I remember one night after... at the club rooms, there's a tradition... You don't want to talk about that?
You have a very freak tradition. I was in the club and the people say throw a chair in the streets. I was in the balcony and throw out. And I say, well, I can't do this. It's not normal to throw that. And that was the tradition. If you are in that club, you need pick up the chair and throw in the street. And I throw them.
it's not actually the street. It's actually onto the grass below. But you are. It is true. At this particular club, it's not a violent thing. It's just a tradition that at the end of the night, people will throw chairs off the balcony, and then everyone will go down very in a very sensible fashion, pick them up and put them away.
And was there the boss of that building? I can say the president of the club, and the president was not everybody threw the. There was there maybe 20 chairs.
Yeah. And that was just. This all sudden. Now, do you have any strange traditions at your club? We'd love to hear about them. Make sure you can get me at Mr. Maximo or message him to at European Cricket, or you can even add the hashtag EC Studio. We'd love to hear about strange traditions because every club is a little bit different. We've got Vishwa, welcome to the chat, Vishwa2891, what is the prerequisite to play European Cricket League? Well, I can answer this one. All you have to do is win the domestic competition in one of the European countries that has signed up to be a part of the ECL. All right, Pavel, we're coming to the end of our chat now, but is there anything you'd like to say just before the end of our Maximo chat hour tonight?
So, we hope this is just the beginning, and we hope if we stay in the house and now we can do more things for cricket, we do this. And we need smile, because it's good to smile every time. Wow. And of course, after they let us out to play more cricket.
We certainly can't wait until you can be out again playing more cricket, and we certainly hope to see you at ECL 21 next year. Pavel Florin, it's been a pleasure having you on, and enjoy the rest of your night. I'm going to cross you out just quickly, and we'll see you next time, Pavel.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for the question. Thank you for everything, and I hope see each other soon.
Thank you, Pavel. So for you guys, we want you to check out our website, www.ecn.cricket, for all the action there. There's stories coming all the time. We've got some interesting things from the show during the week. Of course, European Cricket Studio, four nights a week, Monday to Thursday, 5 p.m. Central European time every day. And on Wednesday and Thursday, we have these one-hour interactive chats. So we really love your company and love to get you involved. And it's your chance to shape the conversation. So make sure that you get on www.ecn.cricket. Now, moving ahead, we're going to go to Monday and Tuesday. And coming up on Monday at 5 p.m. European, we've got Corey Rutgers, the VOC Rotterdam current Belgian coach. He's also an assistant coach with Islamabad United in the PSL. And he's coming up on Monday on This Is McCann. Make sure you tune in for that. Now, on Tuesday, I've got a former teammate of mine who's done amazing things in the world of cricket, Jason Behrendorf, Australian fast bowler. He was part of the Australian World Cup squad. He took 5 wickets against England at Lords during the 2019 World Cup. So it'll certainly be great to get Jason on the show. And I do know that Dorf is a big fan of European cricket and did watch the ECL last year. So make sure you set a reminder in your phone every day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, 5 p.m. German time, Central European time. That's 3 o'clock GMT. It is 8:30 p.m. in India. Tell your friends, let them know about this, because the more people we can get aware of what we're doing at European Cricket Studio, the better it is for the game of cricket in Europe and as a whole. But thank you very much for your company from everyone at the European Cricket Studio. This is Mr. Maximo for Maximo Chat saying, until next time, keep hitting him high and handsome. Good night.